fashion rules again. Yeah, yeah.
Savage Amusement was the follow album of all those great albums, and as you can tell, it took a long time to make, you know. Also, the direction in those days, you had bands like Def Leppard who made all their albums with Matt Lange to point of absolute perfection. So Dieter Dierks' aim was then also to make the perfect album.
The pressure was immense to follow up Love It First Thing. The rhythm of love.
Obviously, after this very successful album, Love at First Thing, was over, we did Worldwide Live because we had the complete tour in the can, and the mixing took a long time, sorting out the songs. So then the band finally came back home and started to write songs. And when once we had the first bunch of songs ready, we took them to our producer, Dieter Dierks, at the time, who listened to the songs and said, it's all very nice, but now please go home and write me some proper songs I can produce. So we all went home deeply disappointed, you know, because we said we probably wrote the next 10 hits.
I think we were getting tired of it and we needed some fresh air, you know, and without having really bad vibes about it, I think it was the tone, you know, you could feel we were ready for a change, but we couldn't go. Can't explain, I think it's love, try to say it to you, when I feel blue,
but I can't explain, just hear what I say, baby. Everything has its time. With Dieter Dierks, this time was actually very long, for rock music is very long, and we did very well, but we noticed somehow the petrol was gone.
We reached the end of the road with Dieter, you know, and everybody knew it. And I guess Dieter knew as well that time for departure was coming near. But still, we had to deliver another record.
We started like in 86 and released Savage Amusement in early 88.
And in those days, we spent 2-3 weeks sometimes just to get the right drums on, and he had this new room which was very high, which was perfect for my drums. And after I had the drums on, the bass player came in and Rudolf playing the rhythm guitar, so we laid down the basic for thing there. So finally we could start working on the Savage Amusement from beginning of 87, end of 86 onwards, till really in March of 88. And then, even then, we were not ready. And the record company said, you have to be ready because the tour in Russia starts, and after this, the Monsters of Rock tour starts in America. When passion roots again, yeah, yeah.
The whole time with Dieter was great. It was very creative. He was a part of the band. He was a part of the team. And he did his best he could do.
After Love Drive, Blackout, Love It First Thing, from Gottfried Helnwein to Helmut Newton, saw. We were about to work with Andy Warhol. It didn't work out, unfortunately. But that would have been the next step for us artistically. It would have been fantastic, you know. I mean, he wanted to do it. The money he asked for, we thought it was too much. But looking back, it really wasn't, you know. It would have been pretty cool. Herman came up with this title, Savage Amusement. And then I can't remember who had the idea with this girl turns into like into a scorpion with a scorpion's tail. But I remember that it was a long and difficult birth, you know, until we had what we were looking for. And I think one artist in New York later on, where David Krebs was involved, get it done, the image we see now as a cover of, that became the cover of Savage Amusement.